Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_037_BIAB_I. You can also download this file from the website. Click the File tab and hover the mouse cursor to Save As, select Project. This brings the Save Project as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_039_BIAB_I. Click the Save button. Go to the, in the last tutorial, we create section views for our project. In this tutorial, we're going to place a home to label the rooms of our building. Go to the project browser and double click the ground floor plan view to open this view. Zoom in into this area. Go to the project browser, pull the scroll bar and scroll down, change the underlay to none. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel, and select the room command. Move your mouse cursor. When you get into an enclosed area, Revit calculate the area and place the room. But if you move your mouse cursor in an opening area, you see the a rectangle with some text near the cursor. If, for instance, if I click, Revit give me an error because the place where I place the room is not a closed area. Now I'm going to select the room and delete it. Now select the room command again and place a room into this kitchen area. Click the modify button. If you zoom in closely, if you hover your mouse cursor into this room, you see series of rectangles in the background. Select the room and go to the property palette, click the down arrow. The name of the annotation is room tag. This annotation has sub option. You can select the room tag with areas. If I select room tag with areas, you see the area of this room, which is 116 square feet. If I select again and select room tag with volume, Revit give me it's not computed. If the volume were computed, I should have seen the volume of this room. Now I don't want to use either of this room. I want to use a custom room tag. To do this, go to the, you can download this custom tag if you want to, or you can continue with the one that the project's coming. I'm going to use my custom tag. I'm going to the folder where I save all my files for this project. Again, if you need that room tag, you can download it on the website. I'm going to click the File tab, Opening, Family. Then I'm going to navigate to the folder where I saved the exercise file for this project and select the file 00_038_BIAB_I. You can also download this file on the website. Click Open. Now click Load and Close to Projects. You see the room tag is automatically loaded. Now if I go to the architectural tab and select the room command, click and place. Click the modify button. The room tag is now in the project. I'm going to select this room tag, click the down arrow, and select the custom tag that I just loaded into the project. You see the office. Also, you can use this with area and it gives you the area. But I'm going to select the room tag only. With the tag still selected, go to the grid panel and select grid similar. Go to the architectural tab, select room command, click to place this room, click to place this room. Now I want to place a room into this porch. Because the porch don't have a wall in the top and the right side, you see Revit cannot find a close boundary. So I'm going to click, you see I get an error, but I will take care of that in a minute with another command. Click to place, same error, click and place room here, same error repeat. Now if you look at this area, you see the room has a limited area because the room isn't fine any closed boundary, but that will be okay. I'm going to take care of this. Select and place another room here and one more here. Click the modify button. Now if you select this room, you see the X line extend to the extreme end of this room. Again, I want this room to extend to this wall. But there is another wall, the glass set, stop the room to be extended. Now, if I want to calculate the area of the room, I'm not going to get the right calculation. Let me select this tag and change the tag to tag with areas. You see, currently the square footage of this room is 154. Rivet ignore the closet because of this wall. To take care of that, select this, zoom in and select this wall. Go to the project browser. You see a check mark next to room boundary. Uncheck this check mark. The current square footage is 154. If I click the apply or I move my mouse cursor away from the property palette, you see the square footage update. So I want you to focus on the figure, the 154 square feet, while I'm moving the mouse away from the project browser. You see the area is updated to 266 square feet because if Revit now ignore this wall as a boundary. If I select the room again, you see the room extend to the extreme end and ignore this wall. So now we need to create another object to handle this problem. To do that, go to the architectural tab, room and area panel, and select the room separator. This can help you if you have a big open room that you want to divide into several rooms, but you don't want to use a wall, physical wall. Zoom in into this area and click start to draw from this point to this point to this point and this point. Click the modify button. Now if you select the room, you see that the room extends to the extreme edge. Let's do the same thing at the back porch. Now I just selected the room. You see the room extends with a limited rectangle. So I'm going to do the same thing that I did previously. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel, room separator. Zoom in into this area and start to draw the room into this reference plane, and this reference plane. Click the modify button. The room is now closed. You can also move the room into a location by using the clicking the move cursor, move symbol to move it where you want it to be. Also the text, if you want to move the text, you can also move the text from location by using this move. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel, and select the room separator command. Zoom in into this area, start a room, start the separator from this point, follow the reference plane and to this point. Click the modify button. The room is now enclosed. The room separator is not only to close a room that don't have a closing area. As the name implies, room separator, you can separate a bigger room to a different room. Now if you look at this project, the living and the dining are almost the same. There is no physical wall between the living and the dining. So how do you label the living room and the dining room? Now if I select the room, you see the room takes up the entire area. So we need to create this division and divide the living room and the dining room also with the stairway. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel, and select the room separator. Zoom in into this area and hover the mouse cursor into this reference plane. Move down slowly and try to snap from that point. Click. Now move down and click. Press escape once to terminate the chain. Zoom in into this third room command here and move the mouse cursor away. Click. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this room separator and this room separator to separate it. Click the modify button. Now if you select the room, as you can see, Revit now ignore the dining area. Let's create another one for the stairway. Now select this room separator. Click this node and extend it to this wall. Right click the room separator, grid similar. Use the pick line command. Pick this reference plane and pick the edge of these tiers. Use the line command. Draw a line from this point to this point. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Start the first witness line at the center of this wall and move and click the center of this wall. Then click on the room separation line is just drawn to make sure that the room separation line is in between the two points. Press escape, click the modify button. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this room separator, this room separator, this. Click the modify button. Now go to the architectural tab and select the room command. Place a room to the dining, place a room to the circulation, and place a room to the stairwell. Click the modify button. Now select this room and click the down arrow on the property panel and select room tag. Click the modify button. So I'm going to end this tutorial for the moment. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to place the room in the first floor plan. If you like this tutorial, please like and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.